Hi, how's it going? My name's Graham.
My name is Chris.
And we're Death and Taxes. We're from Seattle, Washington. Woo! Woo! All right, cool. That's how we feel about it sometimes.
Very cool.
This is a great theater.
Beautiful
space here, too.
And thank you so much. You were going to work for Chelsea Perkins.
We sat in traffic for 2.5 hours after the border, and then I just inhaled a burger like a snake. And it came right here. And I thought that those two things would like meet in the middle of like feeling good. No.
It's been a journey. It's been quite a journey.
Yeah,
an adventure.
We saw a guy eating an ice cream cone as he was going through the border.
That seems ballsy, right? Then I'm gonna cross the border and talk to the guards and give them here's my passport. So that's our day. How's your day?
Good. Okay. Well, we'll stop doing whatever the hell this is. Let's create some improv comedy. That's what you're here for. So, for a suggestion, can we get something you think? Think for a second, though. Something you find extremely interesting. Marmoset had similar.
Killer clowns.
Climate change.
Space rocks. Yeah.
Definitely somewhere.
Yeah, space rocks.
You said it like a minute after I asked. Really thought about it. Some improv and about space rocks. Here at the Fifth.
This is one of those remarkable specimens I've ever seen. You can see tiny contours on it from when it broke through the atmosphere, came down, and then sat in Antarctica for 30,000 years. Oh, this one is most delightful. This was actually brought down from the first lunar orbiter. You can see there that it has a little bit of a click in the side of it, and that comes from a very interesting geological feature that is only present on the moon.
You really love these rocks.
And this one over here, this one is my personal favorite. I know I should
have
my
all of them.
Personal favorite. My personal favorite. This one right here.
You're cute when you talk about rocks.
I
just like how excited you are about them.
But I appreciate it.
Not everybody likes rocks, you know.
I'm afraid of
it. I bet if a normal person saw a space rock and you said, this rock was from space, they'd be excited, but not like you get excited. I think it's cute. The way you like space rocks. And you know so much about them. You're really smart.
Are you making fun of me?
No. This is 100% sincere. I don't know how to be sarcastic. Let me try. Oh, the weather. Gosh. Who expected clouds?
No, you're right.
You're right.
I've been droning on and on about myself. No, you're correct.
I'm only here for the weekend, and I'm happy that we're here looking at your rocks. It's what I hoped would happen.
You're my nephew, and I don't know you very well. How to entertain you on this task of your parents sending you here? I'm quite sorry, but let's do what you want to do.
This is what I want to do. I think you're super cool. I think rocks are super cool. I think not being in Sandwich, Nebraska is super cool. The town I live in is called Sandwich.
We like it, Steve.
And no one even thinks it's funny. Sandwich!
Yes.
Sandwich! Yes.
It's a very special rock. One that I've not shown anyone before. One that...
Not even yourself.
I said horrible things happen to any man who looks at this rock, so no, not myself.
seem so interested in rocks.
Please. Wait, what happens?
I didn't notice.
Well,
sorry, I wanted a cake pop.
That's for you. You enjoyed it. I got it. The cake pops.
Sorry,
it's legend and mythology that surrounds this particular
I'll
rock.
I'll stop at three.
Yes. They say that any man that looks at it will know the secrets of the universe, but the secrets might be so overwhelming that it would cause his mind to melt within his own skull. Are you interested in knowing the secrets of the universe?
To leave on Sunday. Wait, why do you want me to see this rock, Ethan? If it's gonna melt my brain.
I say that the impetuousness and knowledge of youth is the only thing that's able to withstand it, and you're the only young person I've ever met.
Are you
so you're testing it on me?
Are you holding the rock right now so I can look at you?
No.
Okay.
I have two more layers of safe to get to.
I'm gonna melt my brain with some crazy
ass. I want to expand your mind!
Oh, okay, so it's about you. You know what? There's karaoke at an oyster bar tonight, so maybe I'll just do that and leave you here with your rocks, which I thought were really cool!
Those aren't the only safe doors.
Are you still opening the door?
There's no getting out now.
Oh.
Maybe that's the situation. Maybe I should find another lucky little boy. That's the situation right now. I thought that you were.
I'm the only young person you know.
Now?
I want to leave. I went from cool uncle.
Say my name. Hey,
oh my God. Uncle Reba has fallen so far. Come on, I'll look at your rock. Because I don't even know if I believe in all this stuff. I've never seen a ghost. I've never seen a monster.
I know you live in this box and I want you to try it.
Chomp out of life!
Chair and it being
in
the evening, I've had several beers this
year. Here you go, I opened it after I'm sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry. Chomp.
It's okay. No, it's
it's part of the color.
Yeah, no, it was
is this your Sonos?
Is this your Sonos?
I'm going to sync it up to my Bluetooth.
No, don't.
I only have ringtones. Oh, this will be a party! Perfect! Chomp!
Programming. I was
was programmed to do science. I have not done that yet. soda and showing me off to babes.
Robot, if you tell me what you think the meaning of me is, tell me what the meaning of feeling is, I will let you say. What does it mean?
Programming and response.
So it's nothing more than that.
No. Negative.
Robot, let me ask you one more question.
Yes.
Would it feel good if we ended this scene right now? Here it is, out there on the horizon, the comets. Comments are coming. Did you bring that nerd's rope?
After you went to bed.
Mysterious ways, man. Fucking mysterious ways.